Hello, I'm Taras Romaniv, Solutions Architect at Softjourn. Today I'm going to tell you whether Ionic is a good choice of building fintech mobile applications, such as prepaid card app, an expense management app, or a digital wallet app. Let us know in the comments if you have any questions about building a fintech app or about using Ionic. Selecting a mobile app development platform depends on your app requirements, your audience, and your business goals. If you need assistance with a product definition, Softjourn can definitely help. However, Ionic is an excellent app development platform for fintech applications because of its flexibility and potential for getting a product to market quickly. Although Ionic is mostly used for mobile apps, it can also be used for desktop or even progressive web applications. You can even create a mobile app and PWA to cover different user journeys and meet your customers in their preferred channels. Ionic uses widely adopted web technologies like JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. This means development is typically cost-effective and has shorter time-to-market estimate for multiple platforms. Ionic ships with a big library of native-like UI components, and it's truly cross-platform. Developers can build once and then run everywhere. Ionic can help new and established companies build and launch applications quickly and then scale rapidly. With its vast library of app components, Ionic can update outdated user interfaces with a fresher look that meet customers' expectations for a native feel. This really depends on the kind of application you want to build. If you want something graphics heavy, Ionic might not be the best choice. Ionic also doesn't have access to low-level native APIs. This is made by the number of plugins available that provide a wide variety of features and functionality. One of the biggest concerns in developing a financial app is security. However, security is not tied up to any specific framework. Creating a secure app depends more on a company's processes and developer's skills and experience. A good developer will create a secure cross-platform app, and a bad developer may create a native app with vulnerabilities. It really comes down to the kind of app you want to build, as well as any pre-existing technology stack. For example, if you are using .NET, it makes more sense to use Xamarin. Xamarin and React Native are comparable because they use a similar approach. React Native and Flutter let you build a native UI, which might lead to a better performance when built with experienced hands. Still, those frameworks aren't as flexible as Ionic apps, since Ionic is simply HTML and JavaScript under the hood. If your app doesn't need specific native APIs and won't contain heavy UI features like interactive maps or graphics, but you do want a customized look, Ionic is a great choice. Ionic also allows you to maintain a single code base with a single team for every platform, and it can cover up to 90% of mobile app use cases. Which app development process you go with will depend on your app requirements. Ionic is often a better choice than a native because time to market is a high priority for many companies. I hope you found this video insightful. If you have any questions about developing a fintech app or about using Ionic, let us know in the comments below. Bye.